Hello, my dear students. How are you? I hope all of you are safe at your home by the grace of the Almighty. In spite of all these adversities during this pandemic or situation, we are supposed to go ahead with our regular activities. In this connection, today I am Swapan Sarker, Assistant Professor, Department of English, Rajuk, Uttara Model College, Uttara, Dhaka. Going to discuss about a topic from English for Today for class 9 and 10. How to write answers of the question numbers 1 and 2 going through a text-based basis. Question number 1, choosing the correct answers from the alternatives. And question number 2, answering the questions. First, you will be given a passage from the text and you have to go through the passage very minutely to get the idea about the theme of the passage as well as the words available in the text to have a good command or good idea about the passage. It is supposed that you should go through some words, unknown words, the meaning of the words, that means vocabulary, text-based vocabulary, where just first of all we have to know about the words which are unknown to us, the meaning of the words. That means that the words will be available in the text, that passage we are going to read out or we are going to get in this class. First, dense, a lot of things with little space between them. And then heritage, we will find the word there. The heritage means the tradition or achievements or beliefs, etc., that are part of a nation. Indicate means to point out something. Inspiration, the process of being mentally stimulated to feel something. Outskirts, the outer part of a town. Remarkable, unusual, or surprising, which cause people to notice. And reservoir means a natural or artificial lake where water is stored for further use or for future use. Reveal means to give someone a piece of information that was unknown or secret to him or her. Skill means the ability to do something well. And unique means different from everyone or everything. That means uncommon, distinguished one. So these are the words that will be available in the passage. And if we have some ideas about the words or the meaning of the words, then it will help us to have a clear idea about the passage. Next, first, in this way, you will be asked in the question number 1, read the following passages carefully and answer the following question number 1 and 2. So we are supposed to go through the passages first. Heritage is what we inherit from the past. Live with them in the present and then pass on to our children or future generation. That means we are going to have an idea about what is the meaning of the word heritage. Our unique source of life and inspiration is our cultural and natural heritage. Our unique source of life and inspiration. That means the inspiration or the source of life is our cultural and natural heritage. The cultural and natural heritage that we inherit from our previous ancestors or previous generations that will help us live with. Then when you speak of all heritage sites, all heritage, it indicates that the places or the sites that we got from the past and pass on to the future generation of the entire world. That means all heritage sites means, or all heritage means, the term all heritage means the places or the sites that belong to the people of the whole world, not only of that particular area or particular nation. The Shatgambas Mosque in Baghdad is Sasa Heritage. That means one of the old heritage sites that is located in Baghdad in Bangladesh. It became a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1985. That means UNESCO declared it a World Heritage Site in 1995. Originally, the historic mosque city was known as Khalifatabad. That means the previous name or the original name of this area or this area was Khalifatabad. It is situated at the outskirts of Baghdad town, not very far from the dense mangrove forest of the Sundarbans. That means it is located just close to the Sundarbans. Khalifatabad was a Muslim colony. It was founded by the Turkish general, a saint warrior, Uluk Khan Jahan, in the 15th century. The infrastructure of the city reveals significant technical skills in many mosques as well as early Islamic monuments. That means the infrastructure that are available still now in Baghdad that reveals that these are the infrastructures were greatly influenced or greatly formed as per the technical skills of Islamic monuments. Baked bricks are used for the constructions of the buildings. That means the materials that are used, that were used to build these constructions. The planning of the city is distinctly dominated by Islamic architecture, and the decorations are a combination of Mughal and Turkish architecture. That means these are the buildings which were built or planned as per the decorations or architectural ideas of both Mughal and Turkish architecture. Khan Jahan built a network of roads, bridges, public buildings, and reservoirs to make the city habitable. That means this city was not habitable earlier, and it was Khan Jahan Ali who built a lot of roads, bridges, and public buildings just to make the city, make the area habitable. There are about 360 mosques in the city. Among them, the most remarkable one is the multi-domed Shat Gambas Mosque. The mosque is unique in the sense that it has 60 pillars that support the roof with 77 low-height domes. The four towers at four corners have smaller domes on the roof as well. The vast prayer hall has 11 arch doorways on the east and 7 east on the north and south for light and ventilation. It has 7 aisles running along the length of the mosque and 11 deep curves between the slender stone columns. These columns support the carving arches created by the domes. The thickness of the arches is 6 feet and have slightly narrowing hollow and round all. The west hall in the interior was 11 mihrabs. Mihrabs means niki in mosque, pointing towards Mecca. These mihrabs are decorated with stonework and terracotta. The floor of the mosque is made of brick. Besides being used as a prayer hall, Khan Jahan used the mosque as his court also. Today, it is one of the greatest tourist attractions and one of the best architectural beauties of Bangladesh. This is the whole passage that you are to go through the first, and you have to pick up some information will be required for answering the question number 1 and 2. So I hope you have got a clear idea about the passage, about the construction of the Shat Gambas Mosque, about the location and all the things that will help you to answer the questions, question number 1 and 2. First question that will be said in your question paper, choose the correct answer from the following alternatives. That means for this question, 4 alternatives will be there and you have to choose the best one. And 7 questions will be there and you are supposed to get 7 marks from this question. So if you give the correct answers of all these questions, you will get 7 marks from this question number one. First question. In paragraph 2, the author says the planning of the city is distinctly dominated by Islamic architecture. What does the author mean by this? First option, the city has very religious people. The design of the city resembles the architecture of Islamic countries. Third option, the planning is Islamic in nature. Fourth option, all the buildings look like mosque. Out of these four alternatives, you have to choose the best one. And the answer of this question should be written in this way. The process of answering the question number one, just have a look and try your level best to put your answers on your answer scripts in the examination hall in this way. Part one, answer to the question number one, and you are supposed to give an underline. And then you must write the answers in this way and in a clear handwriting. Number A is equal to, in Roman figure, two options. Number two, second option, the design of the city resembles the architecture of Islamic countries. Just have a look. The option is there, the design of the city. The starting word must not start with capital letter. And it is just option, that means a phrase, not a sentence. So you must not put any full stop, that means ending sign of the sentence. It is not a sentence, so no full stop should be there. And the starting letter must not be in capital letter. So this is the way to put your answers on the answer script, best possible way. Next, number two, that means B, question number B, which of the following describes Khanzan Ali best? That means there are four options, four words, but the best, which one is the best out of these four ones? Describe Khanzan Ali, kind, warrior, philanthropic, pious. Out of these four alternatives, you should choose the best one, which describe best Khanzan Ali. So kind, warrior, philanthropic, and pious, all are the words or adjectives, or you can say that these are the adjectives, of course, goes with Khanzan Ali. But which one best describes him? You should know that philanthropics is the word that describes Khanzan Ali best in all respects. So the answer will be put in the on your answer script in this way. B is equal to sign. Then option three, third option, philanthropic. Next, question number C, mihrab is a corner in the mosque facing Qibla, a platform in a mosque, a prayer room, or a place for the muezzin to stand on. So here the answer is, best answer is first option. C is equal to sign and first option, a corner in the mosque facing Qibla. Next, D. The word inherit in the first line best reflects the meaning. To rise, inherit. What does the word inherit mean? To rise, to become heir to run after, or to see. The best answer is to become heir to. That means second option. Same way, in the same way, you have to choose the best answer of the question number E. The phrase our future generation means people who see the future, people who will come gradually, our future activities, or those who come after us. Out of these four options, you should choose the best one, and the best one is fourth option, those who come after us. Next, for if, question number if, which of the following has the closest meaning of the word generation used in line two? Which one is the best? People or age or group or production? Which one is the best one? Number F, second option, is. So, is the second option. Is the best answer, which is in the second option. And for the last one, for the question number G, the main purpose of the author of the passage is to show heroism of Khanjan Ali, or to show the infrastructure of Baghera district, or to represent Shat Gambuz Mosque built by Khanjan Ali, or to introduce Khanjan Ali to the readers. Which one is the best option? The main purpose of the author of the passage is, the best option is to represent Shat Gambuz Mosque built by Khanjan Ali. This one is the best. Then it's third option. So in this way, you have to put your answers on your answer script. And if you do the things, if you put your answers in this way, following all the things I have already discussed about this, about the answers of the question number one. And then if you give a closing sign in this way, or in another way, somehow you have to give a closing sign of the question number one. In this way, you have to finish the answer of the question number one. Next, in the question number two, you are supposed to answer five questions from the same passage. So while you are just going to answer the question number two, that means answer the following questions, you have to think about the answers. Will every answer or each answer will carry 2 marks. And if any question is of 2 parts, you have to give or you have to put your answers in the 2 parts also. And this is the way to get the best marks. This is the to secure the best marks from this question. Question number two. First question, what is Mosque City? Why is it called so? This is how you are supposed to write the answers. Answer to the question number two, and then give an underline of this statement or the phrase. Answer to the question number two. And number A, the city in which the Shat Gambuz Mosque is situated or located is known as the Mosque City. That means first portion of the answers. Then the second portion, why is it called so? This answer is also separate from the first one. And it will carry, it will secure the best marks or best possible marks from the examiners. It is called so because there are many mosques in this city. If you write 2 sentences in the same passage, same paragraph, then the teachers or the examiners may not find the answer separately, or and in that case, you will get just average marks. So if you just separate the answers as per the questions, it will secure best possible answer marks, and it will be very much helpful for you to get the best marks or best possible marks, maximum marks from this question answers. Number two, number B, our unique source of life and inspiration is our cultural and natural heritage. Why does the author say this? That means what does he mean by this statement? Explain in 2 or 3 sentences. Who says this and why does he say this? The answer is, the author of this passage says this. First of all, you have to say in this way, the author of the passage says this. Who says this? This is the answer. And why does he say this? By this, just notice, you have to write the answers in your own language, because the answers, that means the information in the passage is not available, in the same way as you are just going to put as your answers. So these sort of answers will be put on your answer script as your own, and it is your uniqueness to get the best possible marks, highest marks. By this, he wants to mean that the just notice the how the answers is started here. By this, he wants to mean that the things that we inherit culturally and naturally exert great influence on our lives as well as on our dreams and thoughts. This is the own language of the examinees. So it should be your own language. The process of answers is your own. It is your creativity that will differ you from other students or other examinees, and it will secure your best marks, highest marks. In fact, our cultural heritages make us live, and our cultural heritages control and develop our culture. This is the explanation. Why does he say? That means why what is the meaning, underlying meaning of this statement? So you just see, these are the languages not literally available in the passage. It is your own creative, your own creativity, your own command over language. So if you practice a lot, then it is possible for you to put the answers in this way and the answer scripts. Unless you practice by yourself earlier, it is hardly possible to put such types of answers, such types of creativity of your own instantly in the examination hall. So it is better to go through the guidelines and practice it at your home just to show your best performance in the examination hall. Next, question number C, what did Khan generally do to make the city livable? That means we have already known that this sort of area, this area was not habitable. That means it was inhabitable, but it was Khan generally who made it habitable. How? Just see the answer, starting of the, in order to make the city ought living. Just the word is changed here. Just, it shows that you are very much creative. It shows that you have a good command over the language. So just the word is changed and nothing else. To make the city worth living, Khan generally constructed numerous bridges, public buildings, roads, and reservoirs. He also built many mosques. There are as many as 360 mosques in the city, among which the multi-domed Shat Gambuz Mosque is the most prominent, remarkable or prominent one. That means in this way, he made this inhabitable area habitable, turned this inhabitable area habitable. Next, question number D, what makes the mosque unique? That means, why is it, that means Shat Gambuz Mosque, unique one? The answer is, the interior decoration of the mosque and its construction dazzles one's eyes. That means both the interior and the structure or infrastructure of the building or the outside designs of the building dazzles one's eyes. It has 60 pillars that support the roof with 77 low-height domes. The four towers at four corners have smaller domes on the roof as well. These features of the mosque make it unique. That means these are the features that make it different from other normal or common mosque. Which, and it, these are the differences make this building, this mosque a unique one. Next, the question, how will you justify the view that Khan Jahan Ali was a great-hearted Muslim colonizer? Why or why not? That means, do you think that he was a great-hearted Muslim colonizer? If yes, just give reasons in two or three sentences to support your idea. I wholeheartedly support the view that Khan Jahan Ali was a great-hearted Muslim colonizer. Just you may start this answer, yes, I wholeheartedly support. But it is different. That means there are two portions of the same question. And the answer is also, the answers will be also in different portion. First portion, I wholeheartedly support the view that Khan Jahan Ali was a great-hearted Muslim colonizer. And then in the next portion, you are supposed to give your explanation to support or to justify the view. I support the view because he not only turned an inhabitable area close to mangrove forest into a Muslim colony, but also build the infrastructure of the place most conveniently. That means the infrastructure, all the infrastructures relating to the living of the people in that area or were most convenient to the living, to make it livable. In fact, he built or adorned the city with a network of roads, bridges, public buildings and reservoirs to make the city habitable in all respects. That means he was the person who made this inhabitable area habitable. And so in that sense, that means this is the explanation how you justify the statement that he was a great-hearted Muslim colonizer. So this is how you are supposed to put your answers, to represent your answers on the answer scripts. And if you, if you put your answer scripts, you put your answers on the answer scripts in this way, the examiners will also be very much pleased, and he or she will give the highest possible marks in these questions. That means out of 10, you will get, of course, 80% marks and more than above, more than that. So I hope all of you will practice these topics and put your answers on the answer scripts, keeping the guidance mentioned here in mind, and secure optimal marks. Thanks a lot for your patience hearing. Best wishes to you all. Stay home and stay safe.